friend in the, you know, whatever. Anyway, much awaited update. People have been asking me, Fran, when are you going to talk about the UAPs again? Well, here we go. All right, it's just announced. Congress plans first hearing on unidentified aerial phenomena since 1970. And I'm bringing this up now because this is going to happen in the upcoming week. I'll just read from the article. A House subcommittee is scheduled to hold next week the first opening congressional hearing on unidentified aerial vehicles in more than half a century, with testimony from two top defense intelligence officials. The hearing comes after the release of last June, so yeah, it's been just about a year since that of the report. It was requested by Congress on UAPs, and the 9-page preliminary assessment was made public last year. I did a video about that, but yeah, this is a year later. They're finally having the hearings. I don't think there's going to be anything learned, but the idea that it is a process, an official process, it's starting. I think what we might get is updates on exactly what they're doing as far as data analysis and intelligence gathering, because I think the two things I pointed out last video is that the biggest complaint people had about the videos I made before were about the footage that the Navy and the Air Force have been releasing. The biggest criticism is, the military, all they have is these really crappy black and white images. You can't see anything. Well, it's because these are weapons systems, and they're not designed or never intended, there was no specification to have high definition color optical, you know, like a visible light video. These are weapon systems that are just made to track things that have heat signature so that you can put a missile to them. That's all they are. Military aircraft are not set up to have high definition cameras to record things in visible light, because that's just not a mission. But it is now. As was put in that report, that they're putting money and effort into putting onto military aircraft surveillance equipment that's going to be able to telescopically resolve objects. That's part of what was asked for in the report. So maybe we'll get an update on what they're doing there. I think that as that goes on, again, you know, the whole process will take years, if not decades. The things that were said by the pilots over a year ago in the other video I made, especially that 60 Minutes report with those Navy pilots, if they had high-resolution telescopic, you know, visible light video as part of, like, standard equipment on those jets at that time, one of two things would have happened. One is we would have seen something absolutely astonishing, or we would have had very high detailed video of something which could be explained to be something else. Either way, it's a win-win. That's the whole idea of having this congressional hearing. It isn't about finding little green men. It's about finding the truth about what these aerial phenomena are. This goes back to World War II. In the last year of World War II was when it really started, that In all theaters of conflict in Europe and in the Pacific, pilots started being chased by glowing balls and large metallic objects, and they were called Foo Fighters back then. And the flying saucer phenomena of the 40s and 50s, two reasons for that in the 40s and 50s. One was people were aware of it because pilots who flew in the war were reporting it, and stories got around that these things were out there. Foo Fighters were known. And second was the 40s and 50s were the first time that regular people had motion picture cameras that they kept loaded with film because it was cheap, and people wanted to preserve, you know, family stuff. And a lot of people kept, you know, cameras loaded with film in their cars for outings and stuff. And so it's just that as time went on, people started to take photographs and motion pictures of these things, and more people were just looking up. It was just that simple. But really, the bottom line is, with having data analysis and actually having equipment specifically to record and have analysis of this kind of phenomena and these objects, if they are objects, it's a win-win. We're going to find out more than we've ever known. If it turns out that these things are solid objects, then we really should be worried about that because it's either machines coming from other governments or machines coming from somewhere else. But if they turn out to be other things, if it's ball lightning or plasma or some kind of optical effect or some other kind of thing, then we're going to encounter something that we really don't know anything about, and we're going to have to investigate that, and we're going to learn something. So, you know, I'm just completely astonished that there are so many people who don't even want to investigate this, because they say, oh, it's just bull, pucky, you know, Fran, why are you even giving weight to these things? It's just, no, because credible people have seen this. Like I said, you know, pilots don't talk about how that people are nutbags by talking about UAPs, because anyone who's been in the air long enough, if you have an encounter one yourself, you end up knowing a pilot who did encounter one. It's just, it's something the pilots have dealt with ever since the 1940s. So, there's something there that has to be learned. And, you know, so for me, it's a win-win. Either way, we're going to learn something new. So this starts this week. They have a list of the people who are going to speak. Like I said, I'm not expecting anything earth-shattering. I'm not expecting them to say anything that they haven't already published. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. But I am interested to find out the state of things, what the plan is as far as the kind of equipment that they're going to put on aircraft, the kinds of procedures that they're going to have for debriefing pilots who run into things. I'm interested to find out what's going to happen. But that's happening this week, so to be continued. Stay tuned. I'll keep an eye on it, and if there's anything interesting comes out of it, then we'll talk about that too. All right. So anyway, that's it. I'm Fran. Be back here and there, over there, real soon.
At the bench again.